Hi guys, how are you doing? I hope you're well. Today is Tuesday, the 31st of January 2017, and I am in Sunderland. I'm actually in a restaurant called Luciana's right now. It's one of my most favourite places to eat here in Sunderland, and I'm here because it's the opening of Wonderland UK tour. It actually opened in Edinburgh last week or the week before, and Sunderland is the second venue of the tour. I'm so excited to be going to see it. I'm actually seeing it a few times this week, and so I'm going to combine it all into one vlog for you all, and yeah, it's going to be fun. So I am just waiting for a bolognese pizza, which only cost me about £6, which is really good value. And like I say, it's one of my favourite places to eat here. And yeah, I'll show you my pizza when it comes. Oh my god, look at this pizza, you guys. It's huge. So guys, this is the Sunderland Empire Theatre. This part of the exterior has had a big refurb, and it's all like new. And this is the doors I'm going to take to go in and see Wonderland. And the show doesn't start for like another hour, but I'm staying warm because it's cold out here. Hello! I'm fine.
Have you been to the theatre before by any chance?
Lots of times. I love this theatre.
Have you been in the lounge before?
Can't remember. No, I haven't.
Take you up there for a little check around if you want.
Can I? That'd be awesome.
Yeah, tell you a little bit about it before we meet up.
Goss.
So it's just a small little seating area that we have up there. It's been upgraded over the years, but it's always been out there hidden away.
Yeah. What's your name?
Tom.
Hi Tom. I'm Kirsty.
Nice to meet you, Kirsty.
Yeah.
As we get up to the top, we can see what it's like.
Ooh.
So when we bring people up here, we usually get a welcome drink and
welcome
service, and then we take them down to their seats. It's just a little hidden gem.
Wow. Guys, this is so nice. How?
Usually the two of us up here as well, and it saves people going in old bars and stuff.
Yeah.
It's a nice little spot for people to go sometimes.
I think I may have to upgrade my ticket. They're playing Book of Mormon, guys. Now, I haven't been to Sunderland Empire for quite a while, but they've redone like this here. They've got new chandeliers and new glass mirrors where they used to be posters from old shows. And it all just looks really, really nice. I'm loving all these renovations and the cute little tables. And they have a restaurant now as well, which looks pretty good. But yeah, this is all new. Very impressive looking. So I'm going to try and find somewhere where I can buy a program now and have a flick through, and I might show you it as well. Guys, I'm in my front row seat for Wonderland, and this here is the stage. So yeah, quite close really. I'm quite close there on camera. This is the band pit down here. Just show you. And yeah, I'm just waiting for the main curtain to come up now, and I'll show you like a few seconds of that, and it'll be on with Act One. I'm so excited. 6 years of waiting for it to come to the UK, and it's finally here. I couldn't be more thrilled. Well guys, it's the interval. I've just finished Act One, and wow, like, I think I'm going to do a full review at the end of the week when I finish watching Wonderland as many times as I have, so I can give an honest opinion, but right now it's incredible. There are some things I don't like about it, and some things I still love from the Broadway production, and yeah, it's all very different, but then zany, so I'm loving it so far, though, on the whole. Like, It's definitely worth seeing. If it's coming to a venue near you, you need to go and check it out. Like, and I'm so excited to come back tomorrow and see Michelle Pentecost do Alice. I'm trying to find out the minute when she's going on as Hatter, because she's supposed to have two Hatter shows a week. If they're both Thursday and Friday, I will cry because I can't make Thursday and Friday. But yeah, it's really, really good. I need to go get myself a drink because I hardly have any voice left. Hi guys, so it's Wednesday and I am back at the Sunderland Empire, of course, and to see Wonderland this afternoon with the wonderful Michelle Pentecost as Alice. I can't wait for this performance today. I don't know why, I've slept on watching last night for the first time and I've had a good little think about it. Still got some thoughts I'm going to relay at the end of the week to you all in a sit down with you. But yeah, I feel very, very positive about this show, so yeah, I'm quite looking forward to seeing it this afternoon and seeing what chemistries are different, what with Michelle being Alice. I did get to speak to Michelle after the show. Well guys, it's after the matinee and I'm in Starbucks. I've had a cheese toastie and I'm about to demolish a piece of brownie. Like I said, I'm giving like my final thoughts on Wonderland at the end of the week, but I've got loads of little notes written down in my notebook about what I think of the show and the things I like and things I don't. But what I do need to say to you is that Michelle Pentecost as Alice is really, really good. She and Kerry, I would say, are equally matched. However, I do feel Michelle needs a bit more time to grow into the role because it was only a second show. But she did really well. Like, I was floored by her. I'd never seen her perform as a lead before. I've only ever seen her in the ensemble in Wicked. I think that's the only thing I've seen her in. But she was fantastic and she worked really well with Stephen Webb and... oh, what's the name of the girl playing Ellie? I think it's Naomi. Yeah, Naomi Morris, who plays Ellie. She works really well with her, and I just love like their little dancing about the end. I'm going to talk about it more, but yeah, Michelle is a good Alice, and I really hope I get to see her do Hatter on Saturday. Like, I know she's doing Alice for the matinee on the Saturday, but if I hear she's going on as Hatter for the Saturday evening, I may just have to book a ticket, guys, because seeing how incredible her Alice is, it makes me want to see her Hatter even more. Like, yeah. And this is a burnt caramel brownie, and it's going in my mouth. It's nice. So guys, because I'm not allowed to vlog in the theatre, this is what it looks like at night with the blue lights. This is so, so pretty. I don't think I'm getting it on camera because it's a little bit blurry with the lights, but very, very nice. Looking forward to seeing Kerry again as Alice now that I've seen Michelle, so and be able to compare the two. Apart from ridiculous rules on vlogging in theatres, then Sunderland Empire is one of my favourite theatres. Oh, ambulance. And now all these front of houses are going to think I'm completely bonkers for going in again. They'll be like, what are you here this afternoon? And I'll be like, yeah, and what of it? Hi guys, how are you doing? I've just had a shower, I'm really sorry. It's actually been over a week since I last saw Wonderland. I did have a ticket booked to the last Saturday afternoon show in Sunderland, but I ended up not going because I needed to sell my car. But that's another story for another time. And so I've been dying for ages to try and tell you about this show, because obviously I said I was going to keep all my thoughts till the end of the week to tell you what I thought of it. I am gutted I missed Michelle Pentecost as the Hatter. Like, I knew she would go on the Friday night and I couldn't because I was at work. And then for her to go on the Saturday night as well, I was absolutely devastated. I was like, no, I can't believe I'm going to miss seeing her. But I'll catch up with her in York, possibly. Like, I want to see Rachel Wooding as Alice, so yeah, I'll definitely have to try and catch a Rachel Michelle show. But anyway, so Wonderland, I loved the opening. Alice as a character is more defined than on Broadway, and I loved the chemistry between Alice and Ellie, her daughter. That was really good. Like, Ellie's such a great character, much more mature and less annoying than on Broadway, I think. Jack as a secret admirer slash neighbour works a lot better as well than on Broadway, when he was just the husband and then an imaginary character in Wonderland. Yeah, I really like Stephen Webb. He plays the role so well already. It seems like he's really comfortable with playing that part. And when he does One Night Song with the other knights, like the boy band members, it is amazing. Like, it reminded me so much of the Backstreet Boys. I loved it. It was fantastic. I just love watching it, the cheesiness of it. And every time I saw Wonderland, the audience were totally into that number as well. So that was mostly down to Stephen and the boys, I think, definitely. I want to say as well, the ensemble are really, really brilliant. They work really hard because they have so many quick changes, guys. They'll be like all of them in one scene, and then the next scene they're like there, but as like different characters in a way. So that is really kudos to them. Like, and their little parts stand out as well. Like, Divine Cresswell as the Dormouse was one of my favourites, because I swear the Dormouse from Wonderland is me. She's always wanting to go to sleep, and she is always falling asleep. Like, can totally relate to that. Divine, you are hilarious as the Dormouse. Now, in the Broadway version, they had the Caterpillar and they had the Cheshire Cat. And no, that was it. They had the Caterpillar and the Cheshire Cat songs, like one after the other. And for me, I think on Broadway it flowed really, really well. And the difference between Broadway and this new tour version, the Caterpillar song has been slightly cut down, which I kind of miss a little bit. I wish they'd elongated that a bit more. But then the Cheshire Cat number has gone from being a Spanish flamenco style song to a very cheesy number, which I have no time or patience for. And with the change of the Cheshire Cat song, it makes like the Caterpillar scene and the Cheshire Cat scene just seem a bit shoehorned in, because they're obviously trying to cram Wonderland with Wonderland characters. So it's like they feel shoehorned in, and it feels like forced, like a really elongated way of them getting to the next part of the story that they want to get to. I will try and keep, I'm not going to make any promises to keep this spoiler free, by the way, guys. This could happen where I reveal spoilers. But yeah, Kai as the Caterpillar, he's brilliant. Like, I think he is one of the best Caterpillars I've seen, apart from the one on the bootleg that's on YouTube from the Broadway production. But yeah, I really liked Kai as the Caterpillar and his little caterpillarettes, his legs. They were hilarious, and I loved like their connection and like dancing together in unison and things. That was really, really good. But yeah, it's just a shame that really, thinking about it, they seem a little less relevant, the Cheshire Cat and the Caterpillar song. I mean, the guy playing the Cheshire Cat, he's brilliant at what he's trying to do, but for me it just doesn't work. Like, I just don't get the whole new Cheshire Cat song. It's just not right. It doesn't feel right for the show to me. The next part of the story that they try to get to is the bit about the Looking Glass. And I like how the Looking Glass is also now a character as well. It's got an embodied voice played by somebody who isn't on tour, obviously. They've recorded it. I forget his name. Right, the voice of the Looking Glass is John Finnemar. So they've recorded him and his few lines that he has. And I like how he's a character, really, because he's kind of an annoying character as well. He's not got an opinion, but he's like, he basically he answers to what the characters are thinking. And like I said, Act One, One Night was one of my favourite scenes. Sorry, I'm looking at my notebook here, I've got notes. But like I said, Natalie is phenomenal and you should definitely go and see her if you can, as well as seeing Michelle in the role. Dave Willetts as the rabbit is also really good. He's gone from being a scared bunny rabbit character on Broadway to being like this grandfather, judge, fountain of all knowledge kind of character. And it works really well. Like, he was just great. Dave Willetts has got a great voice and he's got a song that was originally another character's from Broadway, I Am My Own Invention. That's another of my favourite songs from the show, and I'm always singing that along with I Will Prevail and Finding Wonderland and The Worst Day of My Life. Those songs really stick out for me, and I Am My Own Invention is just so beautifully sung. I absolutely love it. There is also a new ballad between Alice and the Hatter called This Is Who I Am, which comes near the end of Act Two. And again, Natalie and Kerry were fantastic singing it. Natalie and Michelle were brilliant singing it when I saw Michelle as Alice. It's just a great number and it suits like the ending, towards the ending, quite well. I really, really enjoyed that number. And it was great for the two of them to show off like their vocal abilities in that scene, Alice and Hatter. The Queen of Hearts as well, played by Wendy Peters. She's also really good for the comedy. However, again, towards the end of Act Two, I feel like the limited comedy that the Queen of Hearts has, it kind of drags on a little bit, and I wasn't really a fan. Wendy Peters totters on in these heels, and it always looks like it's painful for her, and I think it's more a deliberate acting choice, but it kind of annoyed me. I was like, say, walk properly in those shoes. Michelle Pentecost as Alice also has some very lovely moments. I only saw her second show as Alice. She'd done one previous show as Alice in Edinburgh. And then she was undergoing her Hatter rehearsals the next day. And I can really see how she's going to grow and develop into the role. I think she's going to be great with a few more Alice shows under her belt. Because obviously Kerry has done every show up until this point. So yeah, I think it's going to be interesting to go and see her again in York, possibly as Alice as well as the Hatter. I don't know, I'll have to see my plans on that one. But yeah, really enjoyed Michelle's portrayal of Alice. It was very different to Kerry, but kind of samey as well in some parts, so I really liked it. The set for Wonderland is also quite clever. It's very simple. There's a lot of on and off rolling stuff, but my favourite parts were probably the Mad Tea Party scene with the bit of set that they used for that, and then in the same piece gets used in I Will Prevail. And then there was also the lift scene and going down to Wonderland with the sets for that. That was also really, really good. The costumes for Alice in Wonderland are all really different as well. Some of them look quite contemporary, like Alice and Ellie. They look very, very modern. But then you've got very traditional style from like the book Alice in Wonderland, like the White Rabbit's got his like waistcoat and his pocket watch and his bowler hat. They're more traditional, and it worked really well. Like, I liked the clash of the contemporary from the real world to the make-believe world of Wonderland. Another thing I really liked was the love duet between Jack and Alice after Jack's been through the looking glass. That's a really, really cute moment between them. Kerry and Michelle as Alice singing about butterflies, and it's just really, really cute. Another thing I want to say about the character of Alice is that Kerry and Michelle are both really good at portraying this desperate woman who wants her ex-husband to take her back, but then the turnaround after going through the looking glass and becoming this strong, powerful woman again and taking control is really inspiring. There's a whole speech Alice makes about her ex-husband after being through the looking glass, and Kerry got rounds of applause for it. Michelle didn't really when I saw her, because I think she stumbled through it so fast. But Kerry made sure that every word was like delivered and heard, and we were all clapping and applauding, like going, yes, we believe in you, we believe in this. And that was really, really good. That really stood out to me as well from Wonderland. And the final thing I just want to mention is the lighting for Wonderland. I think the lighting is pretty much spot on for this show. It really sets the mood for the scenes. I Will Prevail's lighting was one of my favourites. And again, the entrance to Wonderland was really good. The Queen of Hearts cut off with their heads number, that was really well lit. Lots of reds and things. And yeah, it's really, really good lighting. So great job for the lighting, guys. Love you lot. So overall, my opinion on Wonderland, I've tried not to compare it too much to the Broadway version, but I can't help it because I've obviously seen that bootleg and I did love some parts of it. But as a new touring production on the whole, it's really, really good. I think it's well worth seeing. Act 1 needs a little bit more tightening up and a few more changes, but I do think it would not be out of place on the West End. It should go to London at some point with any luck. And I would give the show 8 out of 10. So, yay, love Wonderland. This is the programme, by the way, from Sunderland. It's the White Rabbit going down the hole. There wasn't any souvenir brochures or anything. It was literally just the programme. They did have a very expensive tote bag and a mug for sale, as well as a key ring. But I didn't get any of that stuff because I'm just all about the programme. And that was my Wonderland review, guys. If you've enjoyed this video, comment down below. Give this video a like, subscribe, and I will see you next time for something either theatre or Disney related. You know me. And I'll see you next time, guys. Bye.